I'm Kat Edmonson.
That's me.
I was on a 40-city tour celebrating the release of my new record, Dreamers Do, when the pandemic struck. Tour was cut short, so now I'm performing from my living room every Sunday night, singing my songs and your requests. It's the Kat Edmonson Show. Everybody, welcome. I'm so glad you're here. I've been preparing music this week for you from some of my favorite songwriters. And I have my songs that I'm going to perform. I have a request that I'm going to sing. And also, we've prepared some clips for you. Thanks for joining us for episode 19. Hit it, Aaron. This is a song I wrote called Someone's in the House. What is that noise? The creaking of the floor. I can't remember now if I locked the door. Is someone in the house? Oh no! Perhaps I should, I could get up and see, but I don't want to go. Did I see something move? A shadow on the wall. Shh, what was that? What was that? What was that? I think it's coming from the hall. Oh, someone's in the house. Oh no. Maybe they will go. Like it's me and you and Tyler and Aaron. Someone's in the house. I started writing that 10 years ago, and I finally finished it and released it on our new record, Dreamers Do, that came out in February. Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. Hi, William, George, Carlos, Bob, Tacy. From Facebook, Thomas Daly is watching. From YouTube, Michael Wolf is watching. From YouTube, Phyllis is watching. From Facebook, Isabel Gonzalo. Hi, Isabel. Hi, John McClure. Hi, David Hartley. Paul DeConnick. Rich Peterson, writing in from Northern California. Some of you are writing in from California and the West Coast. And I want you to know I've been thinking of you all. I know there's a lot, all of these fires, and I just hope that everyone is safe and all the people that you love are safe. I'm wishing the best to everybody on the West Coast right now. Hi, Kevin Joyce. Hi, Kara Scott. Hi, Paul McDonald. Hi, Nancy DeForest. Hi, Arthur Alderwood. Showtime, my favorite time of the week. Thanks, Arthur. It's our favorite time of the week, too. So how are you doing? And you're all writing in from somewhere. That's a fact, right? You're writing in from somewhere. Hi, Amy Jo Aleo. Well, here we are, just about mid-September. This is our 19th episode. And I couldn't be more grateful to be here. Thanks to you all for showing up and watching every week. Here's another song I wrote from my record, Old Fashioned Gal. It's called Canoe. Now, when I wrote this, I imagined having sort of sound effects to go along with the song, which we were able to accomplish. And I'll tell you more about that after the song. On such a night in June, beneath the silver moon, they shared a boat for two, canoe. Across a glassy lake, their little boat did skate, and little sound they made at all. And for a little atmosphere, the crickets serenaded, and a few indulging mosquitoes got quite inebriated. They paddled quietly under a canopy where no one else could see a thing. Matt Ray on piano. And as they started to express their mutual attraction, many local residents were having a reaction. Yes, all the fervid fireflies were lighting their cabooses, and concerted katydids buzzing like kazooses. They paddled quietly under a canopy where no one else could see a thing. On such a night in June, beneath the silver moon, they shared a boat for two, canoe. So maybe you heard insects on that track. Some crickets, perhaps. Bullfrogs. Well, I wanted nature sounds for that track to, you know, put you in the atmosphere of the story. And Aaron and I went out one night to his mom's backyard with our recorder and wanted to record bullfrogs and crickets, which sounded wonderful. It was a summer night, maybe June. And this funny thing kept happening when we go out there. These bullfrogs were really loud, and there were a lot of them, and they were talking or doing their mating call, whatever. And every time that we go out the door and kind of get close to the grass, they would stop. And we couldn't capture them. And so then we'd go back inside, and then we could hear them because we had the screen doors open. There they go again. And then we'd open the screen door and go back outside, and they would stop. Anyway, Aaron had to sneak around the house and sneak up on them. And somehow we were able to capture them. That was great. Hi, Lynn Sandeman. Hi, Gigi Pack. Anyone know what type of music this is? Yeah, it's jazz and vintage pop. I called it vintage pop many years ago because to me it sounds like popular music of past decades. Hi, David Kress. Hi, Jeffrey Caswell. Hi, Natalie Norris. Hi, Vernette and Jim. Hi, Michael Cardaman. It's so great to be here with all of you. All right, well, this week I've been preparing these songs. If you were watching last week, I spoke a little bit about Cy Coleman and his songwriting partner, Carolyn Lee. Now, they are two of my favorite songwriting partnerships. And they both wrote with other people as well. And that's really the norm in the songwriting world, especially back in the day when people were writing for Broadway shows and movies and even Tin Pan Alley and all the way up until, I guess, the 60s, the 70s, really. People were writing as songwriting teams. And maybe it was a little bit later. These days, people do write in groups, but it's strange. It's often like really big groups of people, like a whole bunch of people write a song, or just one person. But in this case, Carolyn Lee and Cy Coleman wrote these fantastic tunes, one of which I've had such a good time working on. This was written in 1959 for one of my favorite singers, Tony Bennett. It's "The Best Is Yet to Come." This is Roy Dunlap on piano. Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything's starting to hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Well, wait till the warm-up's underway. Wait till our lips have met. You think you've seen the sunshine day. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? The best is yet to come, come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. I'm gonna teach you to fly. We've only tasted the wine. We're gonna drain the cup dry. Oh, wait till these arms are ripe for your charms to surround. It goes the other way, but that's okay. You think you've flown before, but you ain't left the ground. Wait till you're locked in my embrace. Wait till I draw you near. You think you've seen that sunshine place. Ain't nothing like it here. Oh, the best is yet to come. And babe, won't it be fine? Yeah, the best is yet to come, come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Now, I'll tell you, in my opinion, that song has so much bravado. I mean, that song has attitude. And it's written by a woman, Carolyn Lee. Man, she wrote a great song. I mean, they wrote a great song. But wow, what great lyrics. And they're perfectly matched for that music. Sometimes writers will, or just one writer will match words to music so well. And as a songwriter, when I'm writing, I often try and let the music tell me what it is that needs to be expressed and not the other way around, you know? Because the music, it'll be dynamic, or it will go up high, or it will go loud, or be, or make a bend, and the lyrics must be true to that, in my opinion. So Carolyn Lee, I'd like to know a lot more about her. 1 year prior to writing that song, she and Cy Coleman wrote this song, which is one of my favorite tunes. I learned it from Blossom Deary. And I know a lot of other people have covered it as well. This is I Walk a Little Faster. Sorry, Aaron. Pretending that we'll meet each time I turn a corner, I walk a little faster. Pretending life is sweet, 'cause love's around the corner, I walk a little faster. I can't begin to see my future shine as yet. No sign as yet. You're mine as yet. Rushing toward a face I can't divine as yet. I keep bumping into walls and taking lots of falls. But even though I meet at each and every corner with nothing but disaster, I set my chin a little higher, hope a little longer, build a little stronger castle in the air. And thinking you'll be there, I walk a little faster. Roy Dunlap on piano. To see my future shine as yet, no sign as yet, you're mine as yet. Rushing toward a face I can't divine as yet, I keep bumping into walls and taking lots of falls. But even though I meet at each and every corner with nothing but disaster, I set my chin a little higher. Hope a little longer. Build a little stronger. Castle in the air. And thinking you'll be there. Hope. That's what that song is about. Hi, Sam Stolt. Hi, DeliverX. Maybe your name is Karen. I can't tell. Hi, Kimberly McDermott Mattis. Hi, Luciana. Hi, Kevin Joyce. Hi, James Ramos. Hi, Betchy. Thanks for buying your ticket, everybody, to this show. You can purchase your ticket through cat.live. It's pay what you will, and all of your purchases go to making this show possible. Thank you. Also, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you enjoy this and you're watching from YouTube, hit subscribe. Or if you're on Facebook, like it, share it. I really appreciate it. Hi, Elaine Grasty. Hi, Sigve. Hi from Norway. What time is it in Norway? Hi, Mom. Hi, Sandy. Aaron's trying to tell me something, but I don't know what it is. Aaron's asking me to ask you to subscribe on YouTube, but I thought I just did. Oh, right. Because there are rumors that Facebook might go away, and we don't know if that's true. Not Facebook itself. There are rumors that the live stream might not happen on Facebook. So... subscribe on YouTube. Oh. Let's go to a clip. This is something I prepared this week, and it's for an organization called My Music RX. This is a wonderful organization for kids, and it's kids with cancer. My Music RX provides music to kids that are in the hospital and at home going through treatments. And the organization brings musical instruments into the hospitals, brings music teachers and music lessons and live concerts. And also they have this great website, mymusicrx.org, where... people like myself go on and perform for the kids. And this is to, you know, give them something else to think about besides the stressful and painful experience that they're having. So this is what we prepared. My song, The Best, for all of these kids. I'm Kat Edmonson for My Music RX. Coming to you from my home, where I shoot my show, The Kat Edmonson Show, but where I also just live. Wishing you all the best. I don't think I could love you more, but I could love you better. Yes, I wanna give you the best that I have. Yes, give you the best that I have. I don't mean that I'm keeping score. I just mean to be better, baby, yes. I wanna give you the best that I have. Boom, boom, yes. Give you the best that I have. And when the walls come down, now we'll be standing on the solid foundation. And when the wind blows in, then we'll take shelter in each other's arms. And when the well runs dry, why, we'll make do about the situation. And then we'll get right back where we belong. I don't think I could love you more. Woo! No, but I could love you better, baby. Yes. I wanna give you the best that I have. Boom, boom, yes. Give you the best that I have. Yeah, give you the best that I have. Yeah, I give you the best that I have. Yes, I do you do to be. Beep do do dee dee ba ba da bee ba 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 do be ba da ba 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 do you do dee do ba da da ba boom boom. Go to mymusicrx.org to see other videos. Ringo Starr and his band are on there, and Sarah Watkins and Sarah McLaughlin, and a lot of great artists. Go check them out. You can also contribute to them, and I know they'd be grateful. If you donate money to them, it'll help put instruments or make instruments available for the kids and all sorts of other things that they're doing for their program. All right, so Carolyn Lee was a fantastic songwriter. She also wrote It Amazes Me that I sang last week, and Why Try to Change Me Now? This next song is by Cy Coleman and Dorothy Fields, another partner that he would write with. Dorothy Fields also wrote The Way You Look Tonight. Great song, right? And she wrote all of the music for Annie Get Your Gun with Irving Berlin. I was amazed to find that out. She wrote a bunch of other tunes too. Anyway, this is from the movie Sweet Charity. I just watched it this week on Turner Classic Movies with Shirley MacLaine starring in the role. This is Big Spender. This is Roy Dunlap on organ and Aaron Thurston on percussion.
The minute you walked in the joint, I could tell you were a man of distinction, a real big spender. Good looking, so refined. Now wouldn't you like to know what's going on in my mind? So let me get right to the point. I don't pop my cork for every guy I see. Hey, big spender, spend a little time with me. Do you wanna have fun, fun, fun? How's about a few laughs, laughs? I can show you a good time. Let me show you a good time. The minute you walked in the joint, I can tell you were a man of distinction, a real big spender, good looking, so refined. Spend a little time with me.
Cy Coleman, what a great, great writer. Natalie Norris said, okay, who else is singing the signature chorus line? Speaking of chorus line, I auditioned for that musical in college, and I was cast as one of the girls in the club with Sweet Charity. And alas, I was working at Starbucks at the time, and I was going to school full time, and something had to give, and it was the play, unfortunately. But I really had fun. We were doing some of those Bob Fosse moves and singing that song, and I loved it. Hi, Thomas Daly. Hi, Terry McFadden Abrams. You think Big Spender was written for me? Thanks. I love Shirley MacLaine. She's one of my favorite actresses, and I would love to play any role that she's played. There's a couple that's watching tonight, and they both celebrated birthdays, and they requested this song, and I don't have any music to accompany me, so I'll just sing it a cappella. This was recorded by Frank Sinatra. It's called You Make Me Feel So Young. You make me feel so young. You make me feel like spring has sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. The moment that you speak, I wanna go and play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon just like a toy balloon, because you and I, we are just like a couple of tots running around the meadow, picking up lots of forget-me-nots. So you make me feel so young. You make me feel there are songs to be sung and bells to be rung and a wonderful fling to be flung. And even when I'm old and gray, I'm gonna feel the way I do today, because you make me feel so young. And if you requested that, Burnett and Jim, I assume it's because that's how you make each other feel. And congratulations if you've managed to come by that. More power to you. That's wonderful. Donna DiBiasio, she said that's her favorite Sinatra tune. I got a suggestion last week that we should do all Sinatra tunes one night. That would be really fun, right? He didn't sing a bad tune. Happy birthday, William Laybourne. I hope it was a good one. All right. I'm going to sing one of my songs. This is If. I wrote this and released it on my album, Old Fashioned Gal. If you're going home one evening and you run into someone with whom you used to rendezvous, if the moonlight and the memories carry you away, if it's time to go but you want to stay, if a detour through the park lures you further to the dark, where against a beating heart you feel a spark go through you, if by then you still remember who you were on your way to, oh, I'll be waiting for you if you do. This is the saw lady on the saw. That's what she goes by. You can find her online. And this is Duchess, the vocal trio that's accompanying me. I love those girls. And they've now accompanied me on many a track on my records. If a detour through the park lures you further through the dark, where against a beating heart you feel a spark go through you, if by then you still remember who you were on your way to, oh, I'll be waiting for you if you do. My mom asked me to tell you about how I ended up writing that song. It's very much influenced by the Ink Spots, who are a wonderful band, singers and musicians, starting in the 30s. And they had a very long career, a very successful one. And I shouldn't know who they are, but I have wonderful... my mom has wonderful taste. And she took me to hear the Ink Spots one night when I was in second grade. It was a school night. Don't judge her. And she took myself and my godmother that night, who was in her 80s, and we went to hear some incarnation of that band, because I don't think any of the original players were there that night. But I've always loved their music, and they've been a great influence on me. Thanks, Chris David. Thanks, Resonite. Thanks, Julie Simpler. D. Berger Kosiba. She says, if I didn't care. Her dad used to sing that to her when she was little. That's an Ink Spots tune. I should make a note. If I didn't care. I'll do that sometime. So does anybody have any requests? I'm going to do... another song off of Old Fashioned Gal. This is called How's About It, Baby? I wrote this and I was imagining a Gene Kelly type singing it. I have this fantasy that I could be like Carolyn Lee and write music for a show like Annie Get Your Gun. And when I wrote Old Fashioned Gal, I had a whole outline for a screenplay, for a musical in my head. And I didn't realize it actually until after I'd started writing all the music. But I wrote all of the outline down, and maybe one day it'll be something, or maybe one day I'll write something else. But that idea really turns me on. Anyway, if I could just go back in time while simultaneously writing a book for a musical, it would be Gene Kelly playing in this role. What good fortune I have had running into you, as the almanacs say, once in a blue moon. I've no fancy affair to invite you to, but to stay right here could turn out to be a boon. So how's about it, baby? Look at my amazing view. Pretty as a picture, and the landscape is lovely too. We ain't got no money, but honey, we ain't got no blues. Except for all these blue skies and your blue eyes and the rising moon. Yeah. The way to paradise is through your heart. And if I steal a kiss, it's a real good start. Go ahead, Matt Ray. Tonight's a double feature. First one is the sun recedes. Second one is called when the stars come out. It's in 3D. Oh, I'll reserve our seats right over there beneath the willow tree. Just you and me, so how's about it, baby? This is Matt Munisteri on guitar. The way to paradise is through your heart. And if I steal a kiss, it's a real good start. Yeah, yeah. Tonight's a double feature. First one is the sun recedes. Second one is called when the stars come out. It's in 3D. Oh, I'll reserve our seats right over there beneath the willow tree. Just you and me, so how's about it, baby? While I'm reading through your requests, everybody, we're going to play this clip. It's my new music video. If you were watching last week, we announced its release, and some of you actually came to the premiere either on YouTube or Facebook. Thank you so much for coming. And I want to share this video with you now. This is for Second Star to the Right, which we recorded for our new record, Dreamers Do. And this was written for the movie Peter Pan by Sammy Fain and Sammy Kahn. Sammy Kahn wrote the lyrics, and it's the music that plays at the intro of the film. And I hope you enjoy it now. This is us in the studio. Second star to the right shines in the night for you, to tell you that the dreams you plan really can come true. The second star to the right shines in the night so red. If it's Neverland you need, its light will lead you there. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, so we'll know where you are. Gleaming in the skies above, lead us to. When our journey is through, each time we say good night, we'll thank the little star that shines the second from the that was edited by Aaron Thurston. That was the moment that we recorded that song. The video is on YouTube. Go check it out on YouTube. Subscribe to my channel if you want to. Like the video. All of these things help us connect with you and stay in touch. And Also, I mentioned earlier that we're not sure that we'll always have Facebook as a part of our live stream group or platform, if you will. Anyway, because of that, if you'll please also subscribe on YouTube, and then we can stay in touch that way. Also, I have an email list via cat.live. You can go there and click on a button that says sign up for Cat's email list, and I will also be able to stay in touch with you that way. I just don't want to lose touch if the rumor is true about Facebook. But, you know, we won't worry about that just yet. Let's just enjoy what we have together now. David Kress said, Aaron looks great in the video. He sure does. If everyone wants to know what Aaron looks like, because I know that many of you wonder now, he's the drummer in the video. Thanks, Alex Pobeda. All right, so I've gotten some great requests. One of them was actually that song, so I'm glad we were able to give that to you, Tammy. And this next one is one that I haven't sung in a little while, which is surprising because I'm accustomed to singing it almost every night when I'm on the road. This is a song I wrote with Kevin Lovejoy called Lucky. Like this, your heart upon your sleeve. There's a place in time and space where we can all be free. So meet me at the rainbow's end. We don't even have to pretend that we know what it is we're looking for. We're looking for. Life is just a dream. Ooh, lucky you. Lucky, lucky me. Life is just a dream. Lucky you. Have you found higher ground, or are you lost at sea? Or do you know where you go is where I want to be? So cast your troubles into the sky. They can be the stars in our eyes, and we can count them all another day. From far away, life is just a dream. Ooh, lucky you. Lucky, lucky me. Life is just a dream. Lucky, lucky me. Hi, Jim Bodie. Hi, Steven Rosenberg. All right, everyone. Someone else requested a voice. So that's what I'm going to do. I wrote and released this song on Old Fashioned Gal. And I wrote it when I was going through a hard time. And I felt like, boy, do you ever feel when you're going through a hard time, you feel so vulnerable and transparent that you're afraid to speak. That's how I felt when I wrote this song. If you've ever felt that way or you're feeling that way at any point right now in your life. This is for you. Numbers and photographs do not a person make. I'm more than what a page can say of me. My identity is not in my history. All of the best of me is in my dreams. And if I had a voice, I would sing, and I'd be satisfied. My voice would rise above and carry me. Clothes don't fit me right. Maybe I don't fit in with anything. But if I had a voice, I would sing, and I'd be satisfied. I'd sing away the share of things, and now it's only I who knows what any of it means. Matt Ray on piano. If I had a voice, I would sing, and I'd be satisfied. I'd sing away the pain. I could do anything. What freedom it would bring if I could sing. You might have heard me singing to me in that track. I don't know if you could hear that. I could hear it a little bit. I'm singing along to the recordings from my album. And in the case of recording that song, I sang in the room with Matt Ray on piano. So a little bit of my performance bled into his mic. So we can't separate them. But I hope it didn't disturb your experience of the song. Listen, everybody, it's such a pleasure seeing you tonight and playing for you every week. I hope to see you next week for episode 20 of the Cat Edmonson Show. It's so amazing that you keep coming back. Thank you for purchasing your tickets. Thank you for commenting and making your requests. I send you love this week. All of the best to you. Whatever you're doing, whatever's going on with you, see you soon. We're going to go out with this last clip of my song, Old Fashioned Gal. Good night, everybody.
It's true.
You really do know?
This cake is as good as it looks.
Oh, Kat, sing something. Please.
Okay. Paul, what shall I sing?
Hey, did you talk to
him? Oh, no.
Who's the girl in red?
Tech driven marketplace of communications and aerospace. Are you seeking something far less complicated? If modern day advancements do not seem to you enhancements, but instead abstruse and often overrated,
abstruse.
Are you tired of being assailed by barrages of emails?
Yes.
And are pop-up ads destroying your morale?
Amen, sister.
Well, then look no further, brother. We were destined for each other. I'm an old-fashioned gal. Is it often when you dine that you're also apt to whine? How you wish the spot had not a television? The jokes your date was telling that ensued such LOLing weren't exactly what your hoping heart envisioned. If you would care to dance, but refrain for fear of chance that what they may play might hurt your ear canal. Find this dating site too sleazy, contact me direct, I'm easy. I'm an old-fashioned gal. Bring me a good old-fashioned telephone, one inextricably connected to a wall. Oh, why be a slave to my telephone? And God forbid that I should miss a single call or text or notification. All the old ways of relating, making friends, or even mating now are taking place in virtual locales. Just come over, let's play records. How about a game of checkers? I'm an old-fashioned, I want to be romance like an old-fashioned, old-fashioned.